So I made it to Michigan. It was about a 6.5 hour drive last night. I rolled into this parking lot about 1 o'clock in the morning and just slept in a bivy in the back of my truck. It was a bit of a mistake because it was super dewy in the morning and all of my gear is now a little on the damp side. So I'll hopefully get a chance to dry out my down bag a little later. Two main goals for this trip is I'm going to try to cover as much distance as I can. I can't cover too much distance because my plan is to hike down the North County Trail this way. The Mainstee River also follows it this way. And if I walk too far, then on my third day here, I'm going to walk for 2 days, third day here, I won't have enough time to raft back down it. So I got to kind of play it by ear and see how fast the current's moving. That really depends on how much I can walk. Maybe even the second day I'll have to start rafting back. So we'll see what happens. But really looking forward to the trip. Should be fun. So my first view of the river, Mainstee River. And it looks like it's got a pretty good flow going. So that's something I was a little concerned about. I didn't know if this time of season would be dead. So it looks like I can probably put in a good 20, 25 miles and then raft back on it. So should be a blast. So I've been walking for about half an hour. It's a great day out. It's nice, sunny, and not too hot. The mosquitoes are starting to come out kind of at a moderate level, so not too bad, but I bet they'll get worse later today. So it's 10:40 in the morning, and I've decided to take a little tiny break here, get a little sunny spot, and need to air out my bivy bag and my damp quilt from this morning's condensation and dew. So I'm also gonna eat some food because I'm starving. If anyone watching is a nutritionist, you might want to turn off the video because this is my snack. It's Snickers with a whole jar of peanut butter. Looks really good. Good stuff. So I've been using a gravity filter when I do backpacking or canoe trips, but it was getting a little worn out and I was looking for a lighter weight solution. So this is going to be my first trip where I'm trying out the Aquamira drops. It's real simple, just 7 parts. Part A, and then 7 drops of Part B. Mix it in the cap, wait 5 minutes, pour it in your liter of water, and then it's good to go in about 15 to 20 minutes. So we'll see how this works. Usually I probably wouldn't try this in Ohio just because the water is so muddy, but the water here in Michigan is real nice and clear. So looking forward to see how this works out. I'll give a round of applause to the North County Trail cleanup crews and maintenance crews. They got some really nice bridges. All the trails are pretty clear. A few big down logs, but it's been really good shape for a nice trail. So it's been about 5 minutes, and I don't think you can see it on the camera, but the liquid inside the cap has turned about the same color as like yellow Gatorade. So all you gotta do is just pour it in the bottle. I usually shake it up and give it a couple minutes and it's good to go. It's an absolutely gorgeous day out here today. There's tons of ferns like everywhere. They are very pretty. Keep going through these little pine plantations and then down to the next to the river and back up into the hardwoods. So it's a pretty diverse little hike. This is relatively quite easy. It's very flat. So it's a lot of fun. It's good times. So it's noon. It's about 72 degrees outside. It's absolutely beautiful. There is a little bit of a breeze. I've done about 8.5 miles, so I'm averaging about 2-ish miles an hour, which isn't too bad. I'll probably keep hiking probably until late afternoon. Hopefully you get up to 15 miles or something today. See where we get. But doing real well, drying my feet out. They got absolutely soaked. All the grass and all the ferns this morning were just sopping wet. So dry the feet out. Came to a pretty awesome lookout. You can see how much sand. This whole place is just one giant sandbox. Last hour or so has been a little rough. I've had about 1 liter of water since 1 o'clock, and it's now 4, which that's not enough water. Kept thinking the hiking trail was gonna come back down to the river, but it never did. So I had to, I was just absolutely dying for some water. So I came crashing down through all this thick, entangled, terrible brush and into this mosquito-infested area to get some water. And this was the only spot to even get close, was this like swamp mud. I about lost a shoe in there. My feet are they're completely soaked and muddy now. So my goal is to chug a gallon or a liter of water and then pound it back up the hill, which is a good 15-minute walk, and then hope I can find a campsite that's closer to the water on down the trail. But it's starting to get a little late. The last hour and a half was pretty rough. The first part of the day, I was finding campsites like every mile. There's like a pristine, awesome campsite. The last hour and a half, it was like straight uphill, no flat spots, a mile away from the river, so I wasn't able to find anything. Finally, I just kept walking, and it covered close to 17 miles today, and I found this okay area. The river's there, thank God, it's 10 feet away. I got a flat spot here with no dead trees over me, and there's like a sandy area right there that I can easily put a fire in and not have any problem with it going anywhere. So, it's like almost 6 by now, I'm absolutely exhausted. Got the tarp set up, bivvy's inside. Feeling a little bit better, got some water in me finally. And now's dinner time, and I'm extra excited what I got prepared for tonight. Here's the finished masterpiece. We have 2 servings of mac and cheese for a total of 500 calories. We have 2 smoked cheddar bratwurst for a total of 400 calories, plus 2 tablespoons of butter, which I think puts us close to 1100 calories. And this is definitely very yummy. I would highly recommend it, and it will be used on future trips for me. About 8:15 now, it's been a pretty long day, 17-ish miles of hiking. I was feeling pretty bad around 5-ish o'clock whenever I had run out of water and ran into that mud puddle. That was a not fun part. So I feel awesome now though. I had great dinner, got everything set up, got a little tiny fire going here. Don't need much, it's just me. I got probably like an hour and a half of wood, and I'm just gonna dry out my socks for tomorrow. So. It's good and relaxing.
Just got up, woke up, and there's about 2-3 deer that just ran by over there. So that was kind of cool. We're gonna get some oatmeal going and get on the trail.
So here's the water-resistant bivy bag I've been using. Really like this combination with the tarp. You feel nice and open, no condensation issues. Plus I got the bug net over my face. In the morning, it's a real quick setup too. I leave the pad and my pillow inside. And I rolled it out once just to get the air out. And I fold it over. And I can roll it up. Of course, there's still a little bit of air left. So I rolled all the way up. I got the steel nylon part on the outside just because that's the little bit more durable part of it. And then here's the string that pulls up the bug net. I attach it to the top of the inside of the tarp. So just take it, kind of wrap it around the thing, and I have my sleeping pad and my baby bag all together, one bundle. It's a little bulkier than the two apart, but it's a lot quicker to tear up and set up, or set up and tear down. So I'm getting close to the road I need to be to. It's a pretty cool view. A bunch of ferns everywhere. There's a big lookout behind me. So, not too bad. Getting close to the road. I gotta be on the road for like, I think 2 miles or so in order to get back on the trail. So, that'll be okay. Easy walking at least. So I just completed the road section. The sign back there just a little ways said it was 2.7 miles. So, doing pretty good. I've gotten to this really swampy area. There's cattails everywhere. And if I stop for like 2 seconds moving, I got about 10 mosquitoes around my head. So I'm gonna try to push on here. I think it's probably like another 1/2 mile. Damn camera mount. About another 1/2 mile to the river. I need to get some water and eat some food because I'm getting hungry. So. Get warming up too, it's nice. Here at Elma's Creek, trying to get some water. Filled up both bottles. It's pretty clear stuff. It's actually some of the best water I've seen yet. And I'm starting to get smart. I used the caps for the bottles, and I put the droppers in there so I can do 2 liters at once instead of just one at a time. So, yeah, pretty nice out. It's starting to warm up though. I think it's gonna be hotter today than it was yesterday, but it is what it is. Been hiking now for another like 45 minutes since I got some water. Mosquitoes are horrendous out here. I've sat here for like 2-3 minutes, drank like 1/2 liter of water, and I've probably killed at least 30 mosquitoes. It's actually kind of turned into a game, but they're pretty brittle out here, so I would highly advise bringing lots of bug spray if you're out here. So it's lunchtime. As you can see, the mosquitoes just destroy my feet as soon as I take my shoes off, and I got a bit of a problem in the back of my heel, so I'm going to have to take care of that here after some breakfast or some lunch. That's pretty good sized little blister there. So I was just on this lookout looking down into the river. There's like a sharp bend, and there's these like two couples, and they're screaming at each other in Russian. At least it sounded like Russian, because they're boat was sideways and then they went backwards, and they apparently had no idea how to steer a canoe. It reminds me a lot of my one buddy Joe. He backwards canoeing. It's pretty funny. Almost 2 o'clock. I'm getting pretty darn tired. My feet are killing me. They're just, I think they're swollen. I popped that one blister 2 hours ago and it's feeling pretty good, but they're just throbbing. Everything else is fine. Good to go. I ate plenty of food. Got me some combos. I'm pretty happy about that. But, yeah, I need some new feet right about now. So I've been walking since about 7:30-ish, and it's 3:30 right now, so I'm tired. I'm ready to sit. I was thinking about getting on the raft and rafting back down a ways, but I'm real happy with this campsite. I got a bench to sit at. I got a little fire pit, and there's water about 1/4 mile that way. And not the best wood selection, but I'm just going to be burning hemlock twigs. I don't need a big roaring fire when it's this warm out. So, and there's a good breeze, so there won't be very many mosquitoes, which has been the bane of my existence all day long. So I'm pretty stoked.
So I had some dinner. I ran to about 3 guys that were doing some trail maintenance stuff. They're into ultralight gear and stuff, so we talked backpacks for a while. It was good times. Got the fire going here, and I think I'm going to turn in here in about an hour, hour and a half. Get up early, and the fun begins with the pack raft, finally.
Just woke up. It's about 6:20 in the morning, and it's quite nice out. Yet again, another sunny day. A little chillier. It's probably lower 40s, but I get some oatmeal on me, and then head on down the river. It's only like 150 yards that way, and let the pack rafting begin. Good times. I'm paddling for about 20 minutes, 25 minutes, and I got really hungry for some reason, so decided to stop, pull over on this sweet little sandy area. Got the Pro Bar Super Fruit Slam. It's darn good for a little snack here. My GPS says I'm averaging like 2.9 miles an hour. I think I got 20, 25 miles of paddling, so it's going to be an all-day event, but it's really easy, so it's a lot of fun. And the mosquitoes are like non-existent on the water, at least yet. We'll see what happens later, but so far so good. So I just scared this little tiny family of ducks. They're in the grass. Scared them up, and they couldn't fly. They're too small. They went flying across the water. I've never seen anything swim for its life that hard. Hilarious. Now they're up ahead of me, and they keep ducking underwater. I'm like completely freaking them out. There's not much I can do to slow myself down. So that was funny. This is not the perfect way to spend a Saturday. I don't know what is. About a minute ago, I had my first bald eagle sighting. It popped out of nowhere. I only saw it for a few seconds, but I'm sure that won't be the last one of today. This is like prime territory for him. He was sitting right up here on that log right behind me, that dead tree. This is freaking awesome. I'm doing like, I've done about 4 miles, and I've paddled like none of it. It's just great current. Weather is absolutely phenomenal today. Couldn't ask for a better day. Just saw my first beaver sighting of the day. I'm a little too slow on the camera to get anything. I think this is the cliffs where I saw those people yelling at each other the other day. So we're making pretty good time here, really. Got my GPS set up, 4.5 miles. The great thing about the Packraft is I can take a break, have some pizza combos, and I'm still moving. Here we go, it's noon, about mid 70s out, nice and sunny, and about a mile past this bridge is where my first campsite was. We're making pretty good progress. The last 10 to 15 minutes I've passed through a state campground on the shore. There's two fishermen out, and if you want to get some funny looks, drive a pack raft around, because their eyes are wide and they're squinting at me, and they couldn't quite figure out what on earth I was driving. It was pretty funny looks. Okay, found the hub of dragonfly activity here. There's got to be 10 or 15 of them there. I've never seen that many in one spot. It's crazy. It's pretty cool. There's a giant sand dune. 360. Done 15.3 miles. And I stopped in this little tiny sandbar here. Refill my water supplies. The river moves at about 2 miles an hour, and if I'm paddling at a decent amount of effort, I get up to about 4. Go through some like decent little current spots, and you get up 5, 5.5. So, just in case anyone was wondering how fast the river actually goes, I probably got another 10 to 15 miles left before I get back to the car. So, we're getting close.
So I'm 16.4 miles in, and way up there is a little observation deck. Now that's the highest point of this river. I guess it was a common gathering spot for Native Americans, says the sign way up there that I saw 2 days ago. It's 5:30. I have paddled 25.4 miles today at an average of 3.1 miles an hour. I started about 7:38-ish, somewhere in there, I can't even remember. I about missed my turnoff. My car's about 2 miles back that way, but the river leads away from the trail. So I'm gonna march back up this pretty big hill, and then over there there's some pines with easy access to the water. I'll go up there, hike down, camp out, and then head out to the car tomorrow. It's been one awesome day of pack rafting. The thing is really disgusting right now. I need to go washing. So I've been paddling now for 8.5 hours. I've done about 26.2 miles, so done a whole marathon. I can't believe I went full stupid and walked up that giant hill. I thought that was the hill where I'd parked my car near. So I still got a ways to go. I gotta go past the little bridge. I kind of forgot about that. And then I'm gonna start looking for a campsite because I'll be like a mile or two from the house. So, from the car. After 7:30, did 31 miles today, and I'm done for today. My car is probably another 45 minute paddle down that way, and I'm calling it quits. This site's good enough. I got enough fuel, and there's enough small twigs that I can get my hot dogs and mac and cheese done, which is all I care about right now. That and going to bed. So no big fire for me tonight. I'm super pumped right now. I have 3 bratwurst with mac and cheese on its way right there. Over here on my shoes, you can see that there is sand caked all over the outside and the insoles. This might not seem like a big problem, but the thing is when I was walking, either on the trail or today getting in and out of the raft, is it was a lot like sandpaper. I mean, it's basically just braiding the bottom of my feet, and it was really irritating them. So that's been the only kind of like problem thing that I don't quite have a solution for in this environment. Usually the weather's the issue, but today it was definitely the sand. If you could only smell this is like better than any food I've ever had in any fancy restaurant. This is where it's at.
It's morning of my last day. I just got up, it's like 6:10. I woke up at midnight and I felt like someone was taking an ice pick into my shoulder blades too, like right here and here. It's terrible. It was from all that paddling yesterday. It just they seized up, they locked up in a knot, and yeah, it was really painful. It took me like an hour to fall back asleep after I took some Advil. So I'm going to try to get out here quick. This is one thing I've been doing. This trip's working real good because I bought a whole jar of peanut butter. I think I'm going to bring a little bit smaller size. It's 16 ounces. Next time I'll probably be like 8 or 10. I'll bring like a smaller jar. That was a great idea. I take chocolate bars, all that, and dip it in. One thing I've been liking is I use a bar called Pro Bar. They're a little expensive, but they taste really good, and they have like a lot of calories per weight. Plus they're organic, if that matters. So I take that and I kind of crush it up, put it in the peanut butter, and just eat it out with my fingers, and oh, it's so good. Lots of calories. Like, this kept me going for like, I don't know, 4 hours yesterday. No problem. I didn't get hungry at all. I punched. So I'm home now. It's been 2 days. I had a chance to go back and edit most of the video, kind of look back and see what I did. A couple of things I just wanted to mention that worked well and what didn't. It's the first time I've used a point-and-shoot camera. Used a little Joby pod. Worked great. It was a lot lighter than carrying around the big clunky DSLR and a full-size tripod. So for future lightweight adventures, the point-and-shoot plus small tripod's the way to go. Food-wise, everything went great. I think I was never hungry. Ended up with like an extra few hours worth of food, which I always try to have just a little bit of extra. The whole jar of peanut butter was definitely a win. I used that with the Pro Bar, the Snickers, Hershey's bars. It was really good. I think I'm going to get some smaller little containers with screw tops so I can put maybe like a 4 or 6 ounce serving in there. I don't need a whole big 16 ounce jar.
weight wise, I was right at skin out weight. So that's everything. That's including, you know, all the clothes I'm wearing, everything in my pack, food and water. I was at about 38 pounds, give or take a Snickers bar or two. Which is a little on the heavy side. That's 1 liter of water plus about 4.5 days worth of food. Which is a little heavier than what I wanted liked. I had way too much weight in sleeping gear. The temperature was, the first night I was supposed to get down to 37, so I brought my kind of heavyweight three season quilts, 15 degree, and there's no need for that. I could have gone with like a 45. I ended up just having it around my feet almost every night. It was way too hot. So I could have lost a couple pounds on sleep gear. The tarp and the bivy worked great. It was just the insulation, both pad and sleeping quilt, was probably overkill for the weather. Pack, I was using the Mystery Ranch Trance XXX. It's no longer made, I don't think. There's another pack that's kind of popular amongst pack rafters called the Hyperlite Mountain Gear Porter Pack, 4,400 liter. It looks like something that may be a purchase down the road. It'd save me like 2.5 pounds, which is pretty good, decent chunk. Another thing that killed my weight was the PFD I was using, which was complete overkill for that river. It was, in most areas, probably up to your shoulders at its deepest. I've seen some lightweight alternatives using like homemade vests and then like either making inflatable things or putting platypus bottles in for inflation. So I might try rigging up one of those, and for non-hardcore whitewater trips, I think that's the way to go. Speaking of my next trip, I think next trip I want to do some more rivers. Definitely river, test out my abilities in rapids, and by the time I get to do a next trip, it'll be fall time, so I'll have to kind of learn how to deal with cold water, cold hands. You know, pack rafting at 75 is a little different than pack rafting at 35. So that'll be the next trip. I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks a lot for coming along.